The man, the myth, the legend.
Shit, man, chilling shit. Yeah, right, that's you, bro.
What's up, brother?
Yo, what's up, YouTube? Welcome to another video. So we got a cool little pit stop we did. We're out here at our homie's shop in Alameda Mall in Houston, Texas. We're visiting Exclusive Elements. Our homie AB is about to show us around, show us a little rundown how this store started. There he is right there, man. So we're about to get through, hear a little bit of history about Exclusive Elements, and yeah, we'll get to show you a little B-roll.
Shop is bumping right now, so he's gonna have like a little bit of time to show us around real quick. We'll give you a little rundown of how his shop looks and how it is, but as of right now,
let's get to it.
All right, y'all, so we're right here with AB, one of the owners of Exclusive Elements. Shout out AB, letting us come through, do a little quick little interview about him. AB, if you can just give us like a quick little rundown, like when you started the store, how it started. I know this was like not your first location, right? You had another location prior?
Yeah, this is our third one.
Yeah.
So, and how did you come up with the name too?
Yeah.
Well, the Exclusive, I've always liked that name. Mm-hmm. Everybody uses Exclusive in everything, in anything. So I just, Exclusive. And then Elements, it's just like I said the other day, it was like a periodic table, a bunch of different elements. I got a bunch of brothers and sisters, a whole bunch of us, and I was just like, you know what, man, it just, no, there's not two people that are the same.
Yeah.
So everything's different.
That's dope. And how some different elements go with each other, you
correct.
Know what I'm saying?
Like, correct.
Like a collab per se, right?
Yeah.
And Pollo, like, what does Pollo do for the business versus what you do for the business? We have like your own.
Man, we do a little bit of both, man. But I ain't gonna lie, his stronger point is the back end, the paperwork, and doing all that. I suck at that shit.
I ain't gonna lie, bro.
If it wasn't for him, I don't think we would also be where we at right now. And I'm pretty sure vice versa. You know what I'm saying? I'm the one that's always trying to, you know, be out in the front. Mm-hmm. So you know,
and I'm pretty sure you're sourcing stuff too,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
You make these connections.
Correct.
That's
correct.
How we are. Like,
yeah. So you know, we both have our weak points, and we both have our stronger points. You know. And
how long you been in business?
We've had our storefront. Actually, this September 8th will be 4 years.
This September 4th will be 1 year. Hey, hopefully one day we'll get a big shop like
hey,
this.
Hey man, I ain't gonna lie, man. All the goats are actually gonna be in September because 2J's is September 17th.
Oh, damn. Shout out 2J's.
Yeah, so you know what I'm saying, we're hoping to be there as well. So
that'd be dope.
But yeah, man, it will be 4 years with the storefront.
We started out where before this though?
We were in the same mall but in a smaller location.
Okay.
And then prior to this we were in Pasadena, so that's where we started. And then prior to that we were just out the trunk. You know, we're out the trunk and doing all the pop-ups, all the shows, shit, driving across town, across
and,
state.
And your shop's kind of like ours too, right? You offer consignment as well?
Oh yeah. We do, we offer consignment. And of course, you know, cash out, buy out, store credit.
There's a lot of people that don't like consignment, but we're smart. We have people bring us their stuff that we pretty much don't want to buy. We sell it, we make money off that, and we help our consigners make money too, so we're all making money. So
definitely. Everybody's
happy.
Everybody.
Us as the business owners, the consigner, the customer is happy at the end because he walks out.
Yeah, because consigners, there's certain shoes that they can't move that a shop can move.
Correct.
You know what I mean? Correct. So like a lot of people are telling us that they're having trouble selling just pandas, just basic pandas. We can't keep pandas in the shop.
Right, exactly.
That's like the number one shoe that we move. We always say we have to have 100 pairs of pandas in stock.
Yeah. At all times.
At all times.
Yeah.
Full size runs. Like that's the one shoe we always buy. It doesn't matter if we have quadruples.
It's the new Air Force One, like we always say.
Literally. Yeah, definitely.
It doesn't matter how many restarts happen, you need pandas.
Yeah.
You need it.
It's
an essential.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Essential. Have you seen the new they're called World Champ
has a small little pendant by the laces.
It's a panda. We have it in shop. It's a panda.
It's like the Supreme,
but it's cracked. The leather's all cracked.
I haven't seen that one. It's crazy.
It's just like it comes Supreme with like belt. A little championship belt on the. It's like a little aglet.
It has a gold head. Like small little things. You know, they're just twisting, adding little tweaks.
Yeah,
to the panda.
The Nike Air in the back. We can see over there. Nike Air in the back is white. On the World Champs, it's gold.
Oh wow.
So just little hits like that they're trying to do. So it's no more of that. You know, little leather. It's like dope crack leather. So it's pretty dope. So we've been moving those.
I haven't even seen it.
We moved those at $325. So it's like $5 more.
It's unreleased.
Yeah, $5 more. Right now, you can get something better than a panda. But We still have panels on deck. But
cool. So as far as business is concerned, what's been your biggest challenge for you and Boyle both as far as running and operating this beast?
Biggest challenge. Everyone has
it's a whole other beast here. It's bumping in here.
Man, I don't know, man. I just still think we're super underrated in Houston. I just think the hardest challenge for us is actually advertising.
Marketing,
which I try to do the best I can at it. But I still suck at it. I ain't the greatest at it.
Hey, TikTok, man. We're blowing up recently on TikTok.
No, definitely.
It's like the new wave of things.
We told you. TikTok and do your YouTube, bro.
Yeah.
You can do so much stuff in here.
Oh, yeah. But
a lot. You need the time.
We try. Yeah, and the time, I just don't have it because sometimes I pull up here and I'm like, all right, I'm going to do this. Bro, sometimes I buy one shoe and I can't even put it in the system because
it's so
I get pulled away, AB, and I'm like, shit, man, you know what I'm saying? So
I thought you meant like you sell it right away.
No, not just that, I just get so busy or called on other things that I'm just like,
Something's always happening, right?
Yeah,
I get that.
But, I mean,
I'm gonna try. As a new entrepreneur, a lot of people have DM'd us about one of our videos that we put out there, basically giving people insight or like motivation to start their own store going forward. What type of advice would you give another entrepreneur that's thinking about opening up a shop, on the verge of like snowballing money with the momentum? What would you say? Because a lot of people get discouraged when it comes to investing X amount of money to open a store, X amount of shoes and inventory to have a store open. What would you say to them?
My main thing is don't be afraid to fail.
That's true. That's facts. Don't be afraid of failure.
Because I mean,
you'll never know.
You'll never know if you don't try it. And if it doesn't work out, then it's all good. It ain't the end of the world.
Wash your hands. Do something else. Yeah, you lost money, but everybody loses money.
Exactly.
It's an investment. You know
what I'm saying? But I mean, I don't know, man. You just got to be able to. You gotta be ready to actually sacrifice a lot of time, which I think that's actually the hardest part of owning a business.
Yeah, it's because like when we came here probably a couple months ago, you always told us like you're gonna have that time in the shop, but you also need to have time for your family. You know, it's owning a shop is a whole nother beast. Like we say, is
sacrifice.
Yeah, sacrificing
time, money,
and you'll be, bro. I mean, if you own a business, you can literally be in your business 24/7, 365, and it ain't never gonna be perfect. No matter what you do, no matter who you hire, it's always gonna be something. Something to do, no matter what.
It's like we say, nobody can do our job the way we want it.
Perfect.
I mean, because nobody's James and nobody's Arnold.
Yeah. And like I said, and that's where, just going right back to the whole part of how we got our name. The elements. Nobody is the same. At one point, did wanted to put art on the walls, but as you can tell, the
shoes are on the
wall. Yeah, the shoes, we got the walls, you know, wrapped with shoes.
And talking about shoes on the wall, we see you have it by size.
Yeah.
How we have it is just one shoe's out, and you got to look at the bottom to see
what you got,
what we got. And that kind of sucks, but it's like, it's different when you have all this. You
know what I mean? I think
our store is also a third of yours.
But I still think everybody does their own way.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So if that's working out for you guys, then that's fine.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
How does this work out for you?
Good. It works good, but hopefully here soon, we got something coming up.
So, right, remember you telling us that.
So,
stay tuned.
Yeah, stay tuned. And if everything does go well, as we want it to, then we'll have something else different, you know, a different setup shortly.
So, you said 7 years in business?
Yeah, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, I would say about 7, 8.
7, 8?
Yeah.
How did you and Boyle meet?
Man, we've been friends since.
Boyle, by the way, is the other owner for Exclusive Elements, his business partner. Same like James and I, business partners in Countdown, but Boyle's his other half, per se, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, so you know each other since way back?
Yeah, since about, I would say, high school, middle school. So we go way back, and then, of course, you know, I went off, got married, you know, had kids, and, you know, he did his thing too, and he, you know, then we just...
So when I was seeing you at the sneaker shows, did y'all have a shop already?
No.
Y'all were just vending at the sneaker shows, right?
We were just vending at the sneaker shows. Of course, he had his full-time job, and I was just
grinding.
I was just grinding, yeah. I was, you know, solo, one deep, going, doing what I'm doing, and, you know.
So when y'all partnered back up to do these sneaker shows, how did y'all go about saying, like, all right, well, let's stop doing this and let's go open up a shop? How'd that come about?
I got the water hair up my ass and decided to do it, man. I've always wanted to be an entrepreneur since I was little. So,
had that hustler mentality, yeah, since day one?
Always, always, man. So, you know, so all my close people who know my whole background, like, you know where I came from.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I told him, man, I said, man, like, we went from getting, you know, 5 pairs, 15, 20. Next thing you know, we had 40, 50, 200 pairs.
I know, because I was at the same shows as you were, and then you're just like, yo, what's up? And I'm like, damn, more, bro. Like, it started off with, like, just a little bit, then you just started stacking, yeah, stacking, stacking, stacking.
And how I met him at shows, he was walking around with his famous money backpack, ready to drop a bag with me, you know what I mean? And I was just, that hype girl, so, you know, that's why we're out here, too, for the show tomorrow. But, how does it feel, too, though, like, to be noticed by people like 2J's, you know, people by, like, all the big heads in the sneaker world to come by and visit this spot?
Because you actually have a relationship with 2J. Yeah. You know what I mean? It's not it's not like us, like, we see him and he knows us. We don't have a relationship with him. You
definitely
do.
We do, man, and it's dope. It's dope because it goes back to 2016 when I first seen him at his shop. And I was like, man, like, one day I'm gonna be like him.
Yeah. Bro, I was literally at every single one of his grand openings. Me and my girl, we would fly to Vegas to go to single one of his grand openings.
Yeah, and I just, you know, I was like, man, well, one day I'm gonna be like him. Well, I ain't gonna lie to y'all, I said, one day I'm gonna be the 2J's of Houston.
You already are, bro.
And
hey, you are.
And so, that's dope, man. I'm really blessed to say that we have a good relationship.
That's sick, man. You know, that's what it's all about, building relationships, networking, you know, because you never know where or who you'll encounter along your journey as an entrepreneur, you know?
Yes,
now you guys are helping one another, you know, as he came to Texas, he visited your store, did a small pop-up, I'm sure brought a lot of people that probably never heard of y'all.
Correct.
And in turn, I'm sure, you know, you probably send people to Vegas all day long, yes, wherever they go out there.
So. Yeah, so, I mean, yeah, no, definitely, man, and always keep it 100.
Yeah.
Always.
That's what we always talk about. It's like, literally, when they say, who do you look up to in the sneaker game? We always say 2J's and AB. Like, not even bullshitting, because we're here.
There's really no one else.
Bro,
it's like YouTube, of course, we have other people that we watch, correct, ourselves and everything like that.
But as like a business, sneaker business owner, like, bro, we're always peeping your Instagram. We're peeping, y'all. We're always peeping to see what we can do.
Not lurking.
Yeah. It's always, man, like, we see what he's doing. All right, how can we get there? You know what I mean? So that's,
or do it better.
Yeah, exactly.
Or do it better.
You know what I mean?
Saying, because the moment when somebody says, oh, well, they're not better, they're gonna do it better than me, I don't feel like that way. I tell everybody, hey, man, y'all go harder, y'all go do this, yeah, do that, don't do the mistake that we did, and y'all be able to try to, you know, beat around that to get to where we are fast. You
know, for those of y'all watching, AB is one of our mentors. We look at him like a big brother. He's given us nothing but 100 advice all the time. We've spoken with him, and yeah,
he's literally
looking out for us.
He's literally a text message away or a phone call away. Yeah. Yo, we need help with this, and it doesn't even take him more than an hour to text back. Like, all right, this is what you need to do. So,
like, no, you're stupid.
Yeah.
Don't do this.
Yeah, bro. Like,
and hey, for those who have my number, hey, you already know that it's just close. Because yeah, I just don't give my number out to everybody.
You know? Hey, don't be prideful. Find a mentor, find someone to lean on, you know, a big brother. Everyone needs a mentor in life, you know what I'm saying? So
as a business owner, you can't do it by yourself. There's nobody, if anybody's telling you they can do it on their own, that's BS.
Yeah.
Nobody can do.
Because I'm sure 2J's even reaches out to you for advice.
Yeah, man, he'll hit me up, exactly, and we'll chop it up. And what do you, what do you think? Because his market is different from our market.
Yeah.
So whenever we did the pop-up, it was like, bro, what do you think about this? I'm like, bro, like, I don't know, I've never done it.
It's a whole different thing in Vegas. Like, you gotta remember, people going to Vegas are gonna spend money. Whether they go to a sneaker shop or a casino,
yeah,
they're spending money.
Yeah.
And don't get me wrong, when we pulled up right now, I walked in, I'm like, there's a lot of cars outside, but I don't see nobody in the mall. No wonder everyone's in here, bro. Like, they're coming out here to visit you. So that's what's
definitely
up.
Definitely, man.
Like, you got a lot of supporters.
We do.
Developments is definitely marked its territory here in H-Town, you know what I mean?
Appreciate it, yeah.
This is the only shop we come to.
Yep.
Appreciate it, man.
I'm being real. This is the only shop we come to.
Yep. Honestly, we look forward to coming and visiting you and seeing how much more you grow each and every time, bro. So.
Man, I need to come back out there too, man. I need to make some time.
We gotta find a new spot ourselves, man.
That's what we're trying to find right now. Just a new spot. It's tough, though. It's really tough, but I mean,
it's like we always say, it's in God's hands right now.
Definitely, and I would always say, to be honest with you, you know, patience is key.
Yeah.
So, don't rush it, and definitely just fall on your lap.
Something we have to deal with hard. We've only been open 11 months. Next month will be our 1 year, and we're like so eager to get into a bigger place already. You can only imagine what's gonna happen in 5 years, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, but yeah, we appreciate you giving us some time, bro. I know it's a busy day, back to school season and everything like that, but you breaking away and just giving us like 10, 15 minutes or however long we've been talking.
No doubt, man. Appreciate you always sliding by.
We'll take a look around the shop, see. I know I'm buying something. I gotta get my little man something. He needs to be dripped out.
Hey, compared to the gallery of prices we saw in another certain store, I can say you have some really fair, generous prices, bro. So,
yeah. He wanted a shoe too, but it was a 9.5. He thought it was a 10. I was like, nah, your section's right here, bro.
Figure it out, bro.
But all right,
we'll get going. Y'all. Yeah. Thank you again, AB.
Yes, sir, bro.
I'll tell Boyle we said what's up.
We will. I'll let him know.
Yeah, for sure. So if you ever in H-Town, visit Alameda Mall, Exclusive Elements. The homie AB and his team will take care of you.
You tell them Countdown sent you. Countdown sent you.
He'll give you 100% off your
order. We might end up running a discount code one day.
Yeah, you never know. No promo code.
Not us, not just yet.
We're not there yet.
No, we appreciate it. What way is it?
It's the Countdown way.
Appreciate it. Can I buy a monster? Yeah, monsters, right?